do is put the axis over the MCP. The stationary arm is going to be right in line with the metacarpal, and the moving arm is going to be in line with that proximal phalanx. And you're going to just measure abduction. So you're going to start with the finger straight, and then you're going to have the finger deviate from midline of the hand. Now, interestingly, or not, you guys might not be at the point where you think this is interesting because you're full. We've got first digit abduction. We have second digit abduction. We've got second digit abduction the opposite direction. Then we've got fourth digit abduction, and then fifth digit abduction. So the middle finger, because it is the middle finger, if we're defining abduction as deviation from midline, moving it one direction versus moving it the other direction is both abduction. So your middle finger cannot adduct. It can only abduct. Okay? Obviously, it can return to midline. So in that way, it adducts.
So how do you differentiate?